All right, so that's a 2 rupee range coming in for the next fortnight from Vijay. But let's also get in Abhishek Goenka. He's CEO, India Forex Advisors, and he joins us in Mumbai as well. Abhishek, hi, welcome. How are you reading the corrective decline that the rupee has been doing? Another more than 0.5% of a decline coming in today as well.
Hi, Manisha. As we have always stuck on to the weaker bias in the rupee, we still maintain that. That 53 seem to be making a kind of a bottom, at least in the short term. And we still maintain the levels of 53 to 55 in the coming quarter. As Vijay said, we still maintain that. Of course, we have been seeing so much of good news coming in the market in terms of NTPC sale, and inflation soothing down earlier, and rate cuts by RBI, euro going up. But despite all these factors, ultimately we are seeing the rupee again inching up towards the 54 levels, as we expected earlier. So I think internationally, you know, things are changing again. You know, you're seeing that there are good numbers coming in from the US in terms of the trade deficit reducing, or Aussie dollar is coming down, the risk on trade is coming down, and you know, the Japanese yen is weakening. So a lot of pressure on the I think the rupee and the US dollar is getting strong overall. So we personally feel that till the time we are going to see this kind of a deficit, which is at $173 billion, so much of external debt problem is there, around $143 billion worth of prepayments are due by next March. So I think the pressure on rupee is likely to maintain. So any kind of a strength which is we are seeing in rupee is likely to should be taken by the importers to actually go long on the markets, and exporters I think are still comfortable and they can look at levels of 54 and plus.
So Abhishek, what's your sense for this till budget and in this quarter, what's your range for rupee?
I think till budget maybe 54 to 54.20 odd levels, and for this quarter we maintain 53 to 55 with a bigger, weaker bias in rupee.
Abhishek, you mentioned about the international markets as well. Euro is trading at a 2-week low, Australian dollar at a 4-month low, while the dollar has seen a jump up coming in. What's the cues India is getting from there?
So it's very clear, when the Draghi was very, very hawkish on the euro earlier and the market was taking it very positively, euro went up, rupee became strong. Now when it comes to fundamentals, when the currency have actually come down, the Germans having concern, and the euro, you know, the euro is coming down on the same sense, Australian dollar, they are talking about cutting off rates. So again, you know, the favorite commodity currency is coming down. So obviously the international currencies are not so gaga, and they are getting hammered by the US dollar. I think India will not be left untouched, and India is actually facing its own inherent problems. So any kind of a news which is coming internationally which is negative for these currencies, obviously it's hitting India also and the rupee also. So, and sometimes very important observation that you should see is, even last year in the first couple of months we saw significant amount of flows when the rupee appreciated by around 7%, but then overall in the entire year you saw the rupee depreciate by around 3 to 4%. Now this is exactly what is happening in this year also. In the first 2 months we have seen so much of flows, but whether we can see that kind of flows which can actually help us reduce this kind of a deficit, that's again a question mark. So we need to see a consistent flow and a lot of flows to come in the market to actually bring down this level of rupee again to back to 52 or 51 levels, which looks very, very difficult when in the US, you know, there are talks of QE ending and there are talks of the yield going up to 2% and plus levels. So again, you know, if they stop that QE or even they give a hint of reducing that QE, the first markets which are going to be hit is the emerging markets, and India is going to be number one in that.
All that, Abhishek, your point is well taken on that. So while we are looking at some uncertain times here, but going ahead, some bearishness in the rupee can be continued by the budget and in this quarter as well. Abhishek, Vijay, thank you so much for joining us with your sense on all of those currencies there. But before we go, let's get the ONG